हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग इंजीनियरिंग सर्विस 3 2018 मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग पेपर क्वेश्चन नंबर 19। कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स। वन, द व्हर्लिंग और क्रिटिकल स्पीड ऑफ ए शाफ्ट इज दैट रोटेशनल स्पीड एट विच द शाफ्ट टू रन्स दैट द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द शाफ्ट फ्रॉम द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन टेंड्स टू बिकम इनवर्टेड। टू, क्रिटिकल स्पीड इज इक्वल टू द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स वाइब्रेशन of a shaft when the shaft carries a point load or a uniformly distributed load or a combination of both such loads. 3, the whirling of a shaft results from causes such as mass unbalance, hysteresis damping in the shaft, gyroscopic forces and fluid friction in the bearing. Which of the above statement are correct? Option A 1 and 2 only, option B 1 and 3 only, option C 2 and 3 only, and option D 1, 2 and 3. So to understand this, we understand the concept of whirling of shaft or critical speed of shaft. So this is a shaft, and initially before rotation a rotor is mounted on the shaft and it has eccentricity E with the shaft axis. When this rotor starts rotating, then initially its radius will be E. Okay, so initially the centrifugal force will be M omega square E. So it will tend to deflect the shaft. So finally the shaft is deflected by force amount Y. Then the radius of rotation of the rotor is, rotor mass is Y plus E. Then the centrifugal force is M omega square Y plus E, and the resisting force is K1. Both are equal, where M is mass of rotor, omega is speed of rotor, Y is deflection of shaft, E is eccentricity. Okay, so that M omega square Y plus E is equal to K1. Okay, so now if you solve this equation, then it will be M omega square Y plus M omega square E is equal to K Y, or M omega square E is equal to K minus M omega square into Y. So Y by E is equal to M omega square divided by K minus M omega square, or equal to omega square divided by K by M into minus omega square, and K by M is omega n square. So Y by E is equal to 1 by omega n square by omega square minus 1. And omega n by omega is, if n omega n by omega is 1, or you can say the natural frequency of the system is equal to the speed of the shaft, then Y will become infected. And that speed of the shaft or rotor is called critical speed of the shaft. Okay, so now first statement is, the whirling speed of shaft is that rotational speed at which the shaft so runs that the deflection of the shaft from the axis of rotation tends to become infinity. So that is correct. So Y is becoming infinity. Y is becoming infinity, that is correct. Okay. So second statement is, the critical speed is equal to frequency of transverse vibration of the shaft, then the shaft carries a point load or uniform distributed load, or a combination of both. Okay. So that is also correct. Here the shaft is carrying a load of rotor, and its frequency becomes equal to the speed of the shaft. So that statement is also correct. Third statement is also correct, but there is no explanation for it. The whirling of shaft results from the causes such as mass unbalance, hysteresis damping in the shaft, gyroscopic forces, fluid friction in the beginning. So whirling means when the shaft tend to shaft deflection tend to become inverted. So that can be due to mass unbalance, hysteresis damping, or gyroscopic forces, or fluid friction. So answer is option D, 1, 2 and 3.